we can go over with Peg Keller of setting up dates for all the interviews for the interviews that will be occurring with the candidates who are applying for the CDBG grants. So that's very important, because when Peg and I set up this meeting, it was strictly the hour for her only. And it's very important that we put in those dates at this meeting coming up in February. Okay. I think what I'm going to do is let Tori Eklund speak. She is the new chair of the Committee on Disabilities. And Tori, I'm going to let you talk, and then when Lola does come in, we'll let her take over.
Okay.
And you do know Councilor Eugene Casey from Ward 7?
Yes.
And also our Council President, Bill DeWhite.
Hello again. How are you?
Okay. And also City Councilor Marianne LaBarge. And you probably could introduce Susan, what her position is.
Susan McCreary is our new Vice Chair.
And we have Pat Shaughnessy,
our ADA Coordinator.
And we also have our Secretary, Ruth McGrath, who's also on the Committee on Disabilities.
Susan, can you spell your last name?
M-C-C-R-E-A-R-Y.
That was easy.
Mm-hmm.
Just like it sounds.
That's right.
Doesn't happen often.
Nice when that happens.
Thank you.
Okay, Tori. And thank you all for being here.
So, we want to give you all an update about what's happening with the Braille and large print menu projects. After some holds and delays, Councilor LaBarge and I pushed because we really want to have this in place, and we were able to get the bid on board. I'm looking forward to hearing what Lola has to say. She came to a meeting a few months ago and went over her plans. The bid, who we've worked very closely with on this, is underwriting the project and paying for the venues to be done. And when we spoke with her, she was approaching several restaurants in the downtown Northampton area to see if they wanted to participate. And she had gotten some positive responses. I don't honestly have the up-to-date list. I'm hoping to get that from her.
She just came in.
Hi. Oh, no problem. Sorry, I was a little late.
So we're letting Tori go ahead and speak first.
Oh, great.
But I'd like to introduce you, Lola, to our Council President, Bill DeWhite.
Hi.
Did you get my message from Dan?
I didn't. He's out of
tune. I called him Friday. You had gone off and answered the question that you had asked me. You called and left a message today too, but yes, presentation set.
Okay, great.
And Tori will be with you.
Well, I'm not able to make, 'cause I have class that evening, so Tori was going to take care of it.
Yeah. Okay. And this is Councilor Eugene Casey from Ward 7, Miss Lola.
Miss
Lola, who is the executive director.
Assistant to the executive.
Assistant.
Yeah.
Okay. To the mayor.
So that's what we've been working on and hoping to have this in place. We're asking restaurants to provide Braille and large print menus upon request when customers come in. And very excited about it. I think it will be wonderful to have this accessibility for customers who need it. And I don't have a lot more to say about it, so I really want to hear from Lola, who's been doing the groundwork on, you know, actually approaching the restaurants and making it happen.
Lola.
So I've got two examples here today. We've got all of our large print menus are in, so we need to buy the booklet covers for them, and I'll be discussing that with Dan when he gets back. Budgetary concerns and that, and darker, so this is what the menus will look like for the large print. And their menu's small, that's why I brought for an example. It's only got 2 pages. Some of them have much more extensive menus because they do lunch and dinner, or they just have more items as well. And then the Braille menus are in these nice little booklets. There'll be 4 large menus for each restaurant for lunch and dinner, and then the Braille menus, there will be 2 each in the restaurant. So it's on this cover, and then all of the menu is inside, so if you just want to take a look at that as well. Right now we have 8 restaurants participating: Fitzwillie's, Local Burger, Mama Madonna's, Palm Elizabeth's, Pizzeria Paradiso, Siam Square, Spoleto, and Sierra Grills. And the pricing for it ranged between $135 to $220 per restaurant, just depending on, you know, how much of a menu they had for us to put together. So we did an outreach to lots of people, and those are the ones we got calling back, and we're hoping that as we get more press attention with it, that more restaurants will be open to participating in the program. It's Fitzwillie's, Local Burger, Mama Ivana's, Holland Elizabeth's, Pizzeria Paradiso, Siam Square, Spoleto, and Sierra Grill.
These look great.
They come out really nice.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Read that menu without my glasses.
Can I just keep saying them? I'm trying to write them down, and can I just keep saying them one more time?
Oh, yeah, no problem. Okay, so Fitzwillie's.
Okay.
Local Burger.
Okay.
Mama Iguanas.
Uh-huh.
Paul and Elizabeth.
Uh-huh.
The Pizzeria Paradiso.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Siam Square. Spoleto. And the Sierra Grill.
Wow.
And so bid is paying for all of these?
Yeah, the bid funded the whole thing. So, I mean, obviously, because we are a nonprofit and we're funded by our membership dues, so we have to keep it within our business district. I mean, I'd be willing to, if there were restaurants that were outside of our business district, to give them the information and resources they need to go and get it done themselves. But because we are a membership-driven organization, we have to stay within our district for the restaurants that we consider.
That was going to be my question. Lawrence Diner and things such as that. Okay.
Are these in the restaurants?
I'm sorry?
Are these in the restaurants?
No, we just received them. I just got the Braille menus this morning, and the large print we just got last, I think it was on Wednesday or Thursday.
Mm-hmm.
So, Pat, we can talk after, because I think we can get the Braille menus out that I have right away. But like the large format, because we need the booklets, and you know, we don't want them getting stained and everything at the
mm-hmm.
tables. We're going to wait till we get the booklets for those ones. And we needed to get them back to measure and make sure that we have enough pages and booklets too for the menus, since all the menus are so different.
So, on an email that we received from you, something about you're hoping that many of the facilities help distribute them?
Yeah, we were talking about that.
So, when and how would we do that?
Can I speak?
Yes.
Yes.
We have a committee on disabilities meeting tomorrow, so once all of those are ready in the to put in the covers,
mm-hmm.
Committee members can distribute those. And then the other thing that Lola had asked was putting together a publicity plan, so we can do that as well, and you would be involved with that, so
mm-hmm.
you could be interviewing.
Okay. Yeah, cause it'd be great to get the word out. I think, you know, sometimes when you send messages or call places, because the program isn't already in place and there's no attention on it yet, it's easy to sweep it under the rug, especially restaurant owners that have so much on their plate already. So I think if they see that there's been already some places that have put it into work, then they'll be like, hey, well, why don't we do that? It's not that big a deal just to send our menu off, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So we are also looking at doing reprints for the large print menus 2 times a year,
mm-hmm.
Doing winter, obviously, and summer, because the menus switch over. The Braille, because it is a longer process to get it transcribed and printed out, and because it is a lot more expensive, we're going to have those done 1 time a year. So we can always, if menus do change, we can freshen up these menus for people.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
My question is, I highly suggested that you come to City Council to do a presentation.
right, then I think this is opening the doors. You will have that visibility. It will be videoed in front of the camera, both you and Tori.
Well, I'm actually in class on Thursday nights. So Tori was going to take it because she is the one that actually started the whole project. And I think she knows it very well. So I'm going to send you any information you need from my end because it's just hard for me to miss a class.
Okay, so yeah. You're not going to be here Thursday
night. I'm not available Thursday night. And since Dan isn't in town, unfortunately, it just doesn't work for either of us. But I felt Tori would be, like, totally great for it. I mean, she knows the project backwards and forwards, and I can certainly... And I also think also for an organization like ours, it's going to be better if someone outside of the organization is saying that it's good work. Than otherwise, I find like it's like tooting your own horn, you know?
When we talked with Jan and we invited him to the Committee on Disabilities, mm-hmm. of acknowledging all the restaurants who have helped open the doors mm-hmm. to make this happen for people with those disabilities. So I would suggest that after we deliver those menus, mm-hmm. that I think the restaurant owners, I think, you know, we should invite them to City Council, and I think they should be acknowledged for doing what they're doing, mm-hmm. because we have Tori, who's worked very hard on this for a year, you know, nonstop, mm-hmm. and then we had that break, and we did not want it to sit in the burner the way it was,
yeah.
and I asked Patty that we get David Cruzo back. And thank God you came and opened the doors.
Yeah, it's like one of the most rewarding projects I've done because it's, you know, it's not like the high profile one like when we put on an event that involves the whole city, but it's like the one I can feel the best about, just creating access for people. Like even my parents need the large print menus, so I mean I have experience with that, and it makes me feel good to know that other people are gonna be able to go out and have the experiences in Northampton.
If I could make a recommendation, I think you guys discussed this before, and I think you should do this, is the Committee on Disabilities generate a letter of gratitude that can be presented to the restaurants, can be displayed by the restaurants, and also you were talking about some type of trailblazing or some type of signage that we need to indicate on the door or something, or even on the website or whatever,
yeah.
A co-sponsored project on the bid and the Committee on Disabilities is
So on our Committee on Disabilities website, which Action News takes care of, and then on the city website, putting the restaurants that do have large print and braille on there, and that these are the ones who are sort of starting the whole process off. And Councillor Tasty would ask about like horns, and we're hoping to expand, and this was kind of the beginning point instead of like thinking we're going to do the whole city of Northampton and Florence. So it's a start.
Is there a way, Councillor, of, I like the ideas about signage on the doors of the businesses, acknowledging them, of us bringing them into City Council to recognition?
Well, we certainly could do a presentation to I would recommend that you actually get some more on board too, or, but yeah, because the one problem I see is if you recognize the first six and then subsequent ones come, do we recognize them all in turn?
Well, see, Danny Cruzo got in our Patty that the ones who are starting it off,
mm-hmm.
that he felt that they should come forth, be recognized, and that really opens the doors of other business owners seeing how they have participated in this, and we feel that it would get more.
Possibly, it changes like the flu.
Yes.
The flu. The flu. The first time I ever heard the council meeting categorized or characterized as a flu. That's far off. Susan, can I ask you a particular thing about the menu? Can you read the bottom lines, which are on a finer print?
No, but I'm going to use a magnifying glass. Anyways, the one thing that makes it clear is that it is just a real clear print. It's
right,
not a
right.
scroll or a spread.
A very
print,
simple
and
print.
It's so easy to read with a magnifying glass.
So the reason I ask is I'm not sure why it's in less bold font on the bottom, and it's and
is it
about allergies. It's the allergy warning.
Is it?
And it's in less bold font, and it's, so it's that even looks like it's on a grayer scale than the rest of the stuff. So it doesn't necessarily conform to ADA standards, at least as far as, but you know, it's an it is an allergy warning. I think it has.
I'll make sure to note that for when we do our reprints, and I'll ask our designer to bump that
right
up.
I mean, it's a nice stylistic touch,
mm-hmm.
but it might not serve the purpose.
Okay.
It really is nice to see a menu that if you come into a place and you've forgotten to take your glasses
yep.
out, it's not a matter of fly away. The menu, or have my wife read the menu to me.
Yeah, like it's story time.
Now I have Tori that will keep her business here in Northampton and Florence, and she won't have to go to Hadley. And I think Tori, did you want to speak?
There was one thing I wanted to know about with the Braille menu, right? Are they going to have that also printed? In other words, Braille.
Strictly made.
So it's going to be strictly for people that want Braille to read Braille.
Right. Otherwise, you read the regular and you don't have to have auto cards.
Yeah. And that's what I was wondering. Because, you know, you can put Braille right into the print, right? And have it all on one menu.
Right, but with our reprints, we're doing the large format.
Yeah,
that's
right.
Going to be reprinted twice a year. We don't have the funding to do Braille more than once a year.
But I think Tori could talk about that. Tori, maybe you could help Martin out on his question here.
About the print and Braille.
Yeah,
on the same page.
There's
a transpose.
And you have the Braille would be right in the print.
Well, there would be no reason to do that. Person who needs Braille isn't going to need the print, and anyone who needs print can just use the regular menu, so there would be no purpose for that.
Now, how does someone know that the difference in a restaurant? In other words, say I'm wine dining into the restaurant and I want a Braille menu, but I don't want everybody looking at me, because I asked for a Braille menu. Embarrassing question, in other words.
Sometimes if you want something, you have to ask for it. So, if you are a blind person coming into a restaurant and you heard that this restaurant has real menus, and if the staff don't offer it to you and you want one, you just need to ask for it. I mean, everyone doesn't have to be listening and paying attention and ask for it quietly, but you would have to ask for something if you want it. So that's just
it's also the wine is not a market change.
That's like saying that.
But some people
it would be embarrassing for me to ask for an observant.
Right.
Restaurant and print menus are much more flexible.
expensive. It takes up a lot of space, and then to add to that, you would have a menu that you pick and say, this phone book. If you can buy
I'm very much.
So, committee, I'm going to
opportunity to get together and have a press release and be the big, great, great.
Right, right.
That's fantastic, fantastic.
You might want to get out there on Thursday. All the awards here, the press release was out.
We don't miss one.
It's always good when you can actually have an example.
You said the public contacts, you know, the ones they advertise that.
Right. I have some of those and some of the personnel changes a lot, so it's hard. I have some correspondence and stuff like that.
Thanks.
A lot of people, some of them, they have one overseas, that's part of the door. laid that on
the public.
I know, we could use some good publicity.